My YouTube is Shigeo Honey, and I'm going to do a video today about Chiron in the first house. This is my Chiron series. I am so excited about it. I put a lot of work into this series, so you guys better appreciate it. I'm doing Chiron in the first now. I've completed a few other houses, and I'm not doing it in order. I'm just doing it by random, but I thought Chiron in the first because I have a few people with Chiron in the first around me, and it's actually very interesting to watch how their lives actually, how Chiron actually contributes heavy to their lives. So I thought I'd do Chiron in the first now. So, Chiron in the first. What is Chiron? Chiron is an asteroid, slow moving, and the first house is the house of self, ruled by Aries. Having it in the first house is basically, it's crazy because before I knew about astrology, I just thought, okay, maybe these people just are really vain or have, you know, issues. Like, it's not that deep. But Chiron in the first is not a very nice place to have it. I do strongly believe that it's like a karma to do with your parents, more to do with your mother. And, oh my God, my throat is still fucked up. To do with your mother, your parents, and having it in the first house. It's not nice wherever you have your Chiron. I did a video having it in the fourth house, and I got really emotional in that video because it just touched a place in me that I couldn't relate to, but I could completely empathize, and it just really broke me. But Chiron in the first house, it definitely makes me understand these people on a whole another level, right? So what happens if you have Chiron in the first house? Now, Chiron, so I just got a message, sorry. Chiron in the first house, there would have been a lot of drama around your mother's pregnancy with you, your birth. It would have been a very busy birth. I'm not saying births are straightforward, but it wouldn't have been, you know, have your baby in labor for like 12, 24 hours, whatever. Then you're out, would have been just busy, lots of people coming in, arguing, drama, all types of shit. And then you'll have, there would have been some physical abuse. And it's mad because, not abuse, let me say physical wounds, right? Chiron is also known as the wounded healer. I forgot to mention that. So, with that being said, it's weird because a guy that I know who has Chiron in his first house, he actually has a scar on his forehead, and it's crazy because he said that he got that from when his mum was giving birth and they had to use the scissor things to pull him out. So, you know, things like that. And another friend of mine, she said that her head was squashed as a baby as she was coming out. So it can definitely relate to like early wounds as a baby. Chiron in the first can also contribute to a lack of emotional fulfillment from your parents. And I always say from your parents, but I just feel like it's more your mother, okay? I feel like your mother was nurturing, you know, she was there for you, but you wasn't getting the emotional fulfillment that you needed as a child directly from her. I'm also, depending on what harsh aspects you have around your Chiron, you know, this could also contribute to bullying in school, but it can be bullying to the point where it's physical, like really violent bullying. People would have knocked you out, like done all types of horrible things to you, just awful. It can definitely contribute to things like that. So, God, my throat. So growing up, you know, you would have had this feeling of like you don't like yourself. Not that you don't like yourself, but you just don't feel comfortable within your own skin. You know, you just feel very like, I don't like how I look. You know, I feel ugly. I don't like, you might have body dysmorphia, for example. You know, you might suffer with different types of eating disorders as well. This definitely can contribute to your Chiron in the first. And it can be difficult for people looking in because they may not understand why. because it's, do you know what, I have a friend, yeah, and she has Chiron in her first house. She is beautiful, okay? Gorgeous skin, lovely smile, you know, nice, really nice, vibrant feel, warm vibe about her. And, you know, she's always complaining about, oh, I look terrible, I look shit today. And I'm like, no, you don't. What are you on about? You know? And it's mad because I can't relate to that. I've got a different Chiron. And you guys see me on my channel. I will change my hair. You know, I'll change my makeup. I've got earrings down to here. I don't care. I'm a Gemini rising. I change my appearance like the weather changes in the UK. All right? I change up all of the time. And I may come on here without no makeup, looking plain Jane as hell. And I don't care because to me, that's, I've accepted my appearance. I've accepted who I am as an individual. Chiron in the first house people struggle with accepting their appearance, with how they look, you know? And they tend to be, it can come across as being vain, because the people who don't get what Chiron is about, it can make you do extraness to make yourself look better. So that's what I'm saying, body dysmorphia. These people can go crazy when it comes to like plastic surgeries and shit, getting like rhinoplasties, like you know those, you know, like on Botched. Oh my god, you guys watch Botched, right? It's a program where these people who do suffer with body dysmorphia on like a different scale, okay, they tend to have like 25 surgeries and they go over the top. Who would have it? I've got to look at Michael Jackson's chart. I'd love to see. Oh, he probably had all different. He could have any type of Chiron, that guy, you know. Good. Yeah, like someone like that, basically. That, and that's going to, you know, to the extremes. So these people would, like I said, have what's it called? These people will go to the gym a lot, be on ridiculous amount of diets and nutrition advice, and you know, they're just very much into sorting them, like their appearance. They don't feel very comfortable. Okay, when you have a first house Chiron, these people really feel like the slow moving planets go through their first house. But the thing is, this is, they really need that, because it encourages growth and it helps them to learn a whole lot more about themselves, with it being going through their first house. So, you know, it's easier to learn during that long period than it is to learn without any transits going through that first house. So growing up with Chiron in the first, yeah, these people would have experienced a form of bullying. If it's not physical, it's definitely mental bullying, and it tends to be about their appearance. And you know, someone could say, trying to think of a good example. Someone could pick on, you know, a Chiron in the first house for having really, for having a really big nose. Okay, your definition of a big nose, I don't know, but you know, they may be picked for that in school, and their whole family has the same nose, the family loves their nose, but you know, they're all confident and happy with it. But this Chiron in the first house, this person can't deal with it, you know, they're teased in school constantly for it, and this can definitely lead to this person getting, you know, rhinoplasty or surgery, a nose job, and it can be continuous, getting nose job after nose job after nose job, if they're constantly not happy with their appearance. So these people really need to work on just accepting themselves for themselves, you know. Another thing which is quite funny, actually, well, it's not, but it is, these people, because they value appearance so much and image, if you have two groups of people, right, at a party, the first house Chiron person will see, okay, this is a group of people who look really good, you know, they are dressed well, they are wearing everything that's in season right now, you know, they seem like a cool set of people. Then you have another set of people who aren't dressed as well. You know, they're cracked, they may be ugly to whatever you deem as ugly, I don't know. You know, they got bald patches, you know, their clothes are all ripped and they just look a mess. You know, one person has got a rash all over their face and just unpresentable. I don't know, whatever, all right? Chiron will look past the fact that they are probably a both nice set of people, but they will gravitate towards that group of people that look better. Why? Because Chiron will affiliate itself with beautiful people because they feel like it would make them look better. But you kind of, I don't know, does it work? It kind of does work, you know? Because they look, they deem themselves as being so unattractive that being with attractive people makes them feel more attractive. And it's crazy, but that is what they do. And I feel like they do it subconsciously. And it's just part of the whole 12th house. It's all part of the first house kind of thing. So anyway, how can this person work with their Chiron in the first? The first thing you need to do, because when you're working on your Chiron, it is all about giving back. That is all. It's your karmic debt. It's all about giving back. So how you deal with your Chiron is by dealing with yourself first. It's the first house. You have to be selfish in this case and deal with yourself in a sense where you accept your image, you accept who you are, where you come from, how you look. You need to accept that, and you have to accept that first before you go out and start helping others to accept themselves. All right, how do you help others to accept themselves? Do you know what's funny? What's so crazy is my friend who has this placement, she has multiple different talents and stuff, right? But one of them is a makeup artist, which is absolutely hilarious now thinking about the Chiron and the makeup. And she's really good at makeup, you know, she's really good, she's very much into her nutrition as well. But with her doing the makeup artistry, that is giving back still, and she does it because she enjoys it, but it also helps other people look good. It's all about image, you know, and it's definitely her paying back her karmic debt. So even someone doing makeup stuff, you know, but these people would make really good big brothers or sisters to kids who have experienced bullying, like a mentor. I don't like to use the word mentor because of where it comes from, but someone like a guide, right? So you help little kids, and it's mad. I just clocked she does this as well. I just clocked she actually does this as well, which is crazy. But oh my god, it's crazy, she does this as well. Yeah, so you've got to be someone who has Chiron in the first house. Remember I said heal yourself first and then go into a profession where, or even a hobby or a side hustle, whatever, where you're helping children who are dealing with, who have dealt with bullying, body dysmorphia, eating disorders, whatever, all of this stuff, because this all creates good karma for you. Do you know what I mean? It's helpful to you. So, and also, the last one, like I said, when it comes to the healing of yourself, you have to forgive the people that have hurt you in your previous life. Like, you know, you might be, I was watching TV the other day and someone was talking about she was being bullied as a child and now she's a celebrity. And the woman who bullied her tells her kids that, oh, I used to know her, I was friends with her. And the celebrity girl, she bumped into that same girl who used to bully her in school. And the girl said to her, oh, it's been so nice, how are you? And the girl who was bullied was like, what the fuck are you talking? You made my life hell. How dare you tell people that me and you were friends? You know, it just made me think of the Chiron placement. You have to forgive the people in your childhood that had hurt you. You have to. I'm not saying be friends with them. I'm not saying have any relationship with them. But you need to put that to bed, put it to rest. You know, Chiron in the first, people have to do a lot of work when it comes to their self and also the forgiving, because it just creates a really good karma for yourself and it puts you at ease. So that is my video on karma, on Chiron in the first house. I hope you guys have enjoyed it and I will see you on the next one. I don't know what, which one should I do? Anyway, you guys tell me what Chiron video you want to see next. It might be the 8th, but you guys tell me and I'll decide whether I'll do your video or the 8th. I don't know yet, but let me know in the comments below. And go through my other Chiron videos, they're really interesting, alright?